It's sexual suicide. Christendom and the Republic are ending in sexual suicide, the destruction of the family, and of course, mass annihilation through abortion. It couldn't be worse. It couldn't. And they sacrifice those babies to Satan.
Well, it's come out, a lot of them have admitted that they are Satanists, and it's a sacrament to them. It's total abomination. Thank you so much, sir. God bless you. Thanks for coming out. All right, folks, Jakari Jackson's been leading this thing. I kind of came down here and hijacked our operation because that'll be a new conspiracy to hijack my own demonstration. Again, I want to thank you all for coming out here. We're going to be out here for another hour. David Knight's back at the studio. I know we can't skip this break coming up here in just a moment. David Knight, take us out to break. We're going to come back and talk to some more of these folks, okay?
All right, we'll do, Alex. As we've seen before, when we go to cover these rallies, it was at the state capitol that we were covering a gun control rally, and there were two protesters there protesting gun control, holding up signs that this was going to be about banning all firearms. If you remember that clip that we pulled out where the mayor pro tem said, "You hang on to that sign. We're not doing that just yet, but we're going to make that sign come true." Well, it was also at that rally that everyone else there tried to cover up the signs of just two protesters who were there, two counter-protesters. They could not allow them to hold their sign up. They wanted to cover it up. That's precisely what we've seen here at this protest at the Planned Parenthood site in Austin. Rather than showing up and telling people why they should have an abortion or try to push back against any arguments, they simply want to censor other people's free speech. When we come back after the break, we're going to talk about an article that's up on Infowars.com about how this is happening across college campuses. Free speech zones, permission to exercise your First Amendment, because they don't respect the right to life, they don't respect the right to keep and bear arms, and they don't respect your free speech. Stay with us. We'll be right back. Go ahead, Alex.
Absolutely, and we're here. I'm seeing new crowds come all the time, probably about 60 people here now, a lot of new faces. People just pop through for 20 minutes, go back to work, like Mr. Jackson. Not Jakari Jackson, another Jackson. You just popped by real quick. What's your take on this?
I think we should save the babies, have this place shut down, just get rid of all this stuff.
Absolutely. Anything else you'd like to add?
God bless America.
All right, brother.
Give me some help, brother.
All right, absolutely. Sir?
Yeah, people just don't know. People just don't know this information. It's up to everyone to break out of their comfort zone and tell the people that they're uncomfortable telling about this information so that we can spread it to everyone.
Absolutely.
Force a debate on this.
You know? Absolutely,
Jesse Jackson, Al Sharpton, Obama, they don't want to have a debate on this.
And yeah, this is really the big deal. Sir, what's your take on all this?
Yeah. Well, I've been studying Margaret Sanger for years. She's the killer.
She's the worst.
That's all. Yeah, she is. She really is. Most people, it's good work that you're doing educating people because most people don't know about her at all. You know, I was at ACC about a couple months ago, and she was there in a black women's conference, and it was ridiculous, the amount of ignorance.
I mean, some of the representatives.
Right, absolutely.
Yeah.
It's a great work.
What do you think of the folks out here saying we're racist and Jakari's racist because we don't want to have half the blacks killed?
Well, I would ignore them. That's what I would do. I would ignore them if I was you.
But what do you call these fake liberals that are actually racist, like Margaret Sanger, who then take the moral high ground and say, if you don't want to kill 57 million or 56 million babies, you're racist?
It's deception. That's all it is. Deception. You know it better than I do. You know, you've done massive research.
No, enough about me. You guys are the people out here, and I salute you all. Who else wants to get on this mic and say a few words?
Anything else, brother?
No, just try to.
I just always encourage how it's so easy for you to get out there, speak your mind and all that. And that really motivates me and gives me a lot of courage to question, you know, whatever we have to question about our government. I'm a veteran, but it's always good to question everything. And I'm, you know, I'm motivated by you always questioning everything. It's awesome.
That's what I'm trying to do. God bless you. Ma'am, do you have anything you'd like to add?
I just cannot believe that anybody stands for this, to have this many babies killed every day. This has got to stop.
And now it's put the vets on a don't treat list. Now it's kill the old people.
Right.
I mean, it's just never going to end.
No, it's never going to end unless we stop it. Unless everybody stands up as one and stops it.
Absolutely. Who else wants to jump in here?
A conception should not be a death sentence. God bless you, Alex.
God bless you, my friend.
What's up? It's a natural progression of people who hate themselves. Once they realize that we're all the same and everyone, there's a part of us in everyone, then they realize that they're just killing themselves. So.
Well, that's it. When they're killing any baby, I feel it in my soul and I get mad.
Well, it's because we're all.
I mean, I'll be honest. I didn't come out here because I have really aggressive feelings towards these demons.
Yeah, I mean, we're all connected.
Which one of them would have hit me?
As you rise to higher levels of consciousness, you realize that everyone's connected and you can kind of feel what everyone else is feeling. So. You know, you just have to realize that, and if you treat everyone else the way you wanted to be treated, you know, you can't go wrong with the golden rule. I don't know why it's that.
Well, that's what I've done in my life, and God's only blessed me and protected me.
Oh, absolutely, and we're all connected in the end with, you know, a higher spirit and a higher power that will eventually bring us all together.
So. Well, I think the wicked side is getting really scared because there is a human consciousness happening.
Well, the wicked side knows that the good always wins in the end. It's written in every major book and every story, from Lord of the Rings to The Matrix to every motion picture. It all comes from the same source. So
they know, the archetype.
They know they're gonna lose, so you know they're clawing at the bits to try to make it. And at the end of the day, when you know you're gonna lose, you're gonna try everything. But
did you see? And I'm not trying to be mean. How soulless those guys were. Their eyes were all dead.
Oh, I mean, they can't even talk or have a conversation. I don't know why you would come out here and try to protest something unless you're just being brainwashed and told what to do by someone else. It's the inability of someone to think for themselves and decide. This is good, this is bad, this is helpful, this is not. It's just basically automatons from, you know, the stuff in the water.
We'll be right back. Stay with us. You did it. When you showed up, they dropped their tarps and ran off. And she says she's got one of their tarps as a souvenir.
Amazing. Well, we're down here pointing out that all Black Lives Matter, all lives matter, and that the very people who want to literally wipe out Black Americans through Planned Parenthood on record are the ones trying to create this whole race war and garbage off some of these tragedies. So we're pointing out the real organized genocide with the documented proof. We're talking to a lot of great folks. Sir, give us your take on all this.
Yeah, I think that if we're going to continue forward as a country.
Excuse us! Pardon us! Excuse us! Pardon us! Excuse us! Pardon us! Excuse us!
What's wrong? Oh, they're coming back. They masked
the attack.
These people
are
getting
shoving
and pushing people, grabbing the mic.
We're just assaulted. Get the cops. Get the cops. That guy's, we got the witness.
I guess they don't realize this is being broadcast live. Too stupid to know that.
Now he's hitting.
Hey.
All right, that's clear assault. Get the police over here. Do you have audio? He tried to take the mic.
I got video.
Do we have audio?
They came in and tried to drag the mic off.
He's coming at me again right now.
Yelling, excuse us,
and
came back as a group.
Go ahead.
This is amazing. These people don't have anything to say. They just want to shut your free speech down.
Bro, you got to tell, bro.
You got to say this. I take him down.
Okay.
Yeah, we got this. Is insane.
Push and shove.
This guy was totally demon possessed.
Unbelievable.
Let me get the police here right now. Look, another minion attacking.
Get out of here.
Get the.
You people are devil worshippers, and we see it. Your God's fallen.
You're a fucking bitch.
Your God's fallen.
Catch that guy.
You're weak. Your God's weak.
Y'all are all being killed.
God bless you, brother.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Look at these guys.
Oh, it just came in and punched Alex and just pulled out his mic. So we just lost the mic. Hit and run. That's the tactic that they do. They try to shut down your free speech. You need to understand that these people who have been telling us that they're pro-choice for so long are the ones who are, he's running off trying to steal a mic. They're chasing him down. I think he actually got the microphone, pulled it off of the cord. They're following him now. These are the people telling you that they're pro-choice. They want to shut down all of your choice about not only which insurance company, what level of coverage you're going to have. They want to shut down your choice about vaccines. They want to force inject you. It's a medical tyranny. They don't want to have a discussion about anything. They don't have any signs. They just come up to shut down our signs. What we're trying to do, and as one of the callers that was one of the people at the protest pointed out, when he talks to people about genocide, they don't even understand what he's talking about. They say they're just profoundly ignorant, and they don't understand or know about the conspiracy quotes from Margaret Sanger. It's not a theory. There's conspiracy quotes where she says she wants to do genocide, shut down the Black people, shut down the undesirable races. As she said, we're either going to segregate them or we are going to sterilize them. She was the founder of Planned Parenthood. And as the one of the protesters there said, when he talks to people, they don't know anything about the origins of Planned Parenthood. They don't know who Margaret Sanger is. They've never read any of the things that she said. and they don't even understand what eugenics or genocide are about. They're profoundly ignorant. That's why it's an information war. Right now, they got the microphone back, I think, and they're trying to get us hooked up here. Okay,
there we are.
Here's Alex.
Can you hear anything?
Okay, Alex, you're back. We got you live. Can you hear us? Okay, what happened was we had a momentary case. A guy ran up.
Did you see that, Dima?
I mean, no fight with him.
Do we have audio yet?
You got audio. Go ahead. Go ahead, Alex. You got audio.
Okay, good.
He can't hear us. The guy came up and... assaulted Alex and grabbed the microphone and ran off. They chased him down and got the microphone back. And Alex is still trying to get connected up. He can't hear that we're here. Yes, go ahead. You're on. Go ahead.
Can you hear me, David?
Yes, I got you. Go ahead, Alex.
Yes.
Okay, thank God we always take two bullhorns because we've had MSNBC attack us with knives and cut the cord before at the DNC in Denver. We just got attacked again. They're arresting him over here. Let's get the footage. I'll go tell the police what happened. All of this is unfolding. We had it all on footage. A literal vampire with see-through white skin. These are literal demon-possessed people, folks. This is like a movie. They are literally scum of the earth. And I saw their controller driving around earlier in a black car, looked like a vampire. These people are so weak. And they're fluttering around their temple trying to protect it. Because make no mistake, rituals go on in that building. We've caught them all over the country, folks. This is what's really going on. And he assaulted a bunch of people. People controlled themselves. He was going to attack me. Jakari got between us. Great job, Jakari. He was totally possessed. Rob, dude, describe what you saw.
That guy had a look in his eyes of death and soullessness, and he was like just, you could just see it. He was going, and it was like when those guys in Iraq were like killing the puppy and beating up the kids. It was that same mentality.
It's the enemy. You saw the enemy.
Oh, yeah. You could see it right there. And he was the worst. The other ones didn't have that look. That guy had the look, and we got it all on tape, and we're going to be putting it up. It was all streamed out live, too. So I'm totally blown away.
This is a pack of vampires.
I got them from behind coming in. They all linked
up. We know who they are. I want to start hunting them in the info war.
Right.
I want to start going to their haunts. Yeah. I want to put some legal, lawful teams on them.
They're all right behind us.
Yeah. Well, and where are the police? They're over there arresting the ringwraiths right now. We need to send somebody over to talk to the police so that they can get the truth of what happened so they don't let them go. We have it all on footage. We have everything on tape. We need the Austin police to come over here. They've already been helpful so far. Let's send over Jakari. Jakari!
I think Weldon saw it, too.
He's okay, Weldon. Yeah, I want to get the police over here as soon as they get people. Pardon me, sir? No, sir.
Okay.
God bless you. I want to tell the police exactly what happened. That guy shoved, hit, punched, kicked, and he did it all like that animated demon thing where they have no souls. Like in movies. I mean, these people are literal scum. Literal filth. Absolute bottom of the barrel trash. Here, like moths in a flame, at the stench of the dead babies in there, just getting off on it at every level. And their evil has exposed them yet again. I mean, look at this guy. It's like the hillside. I mean, it's just unbelievable, the emptiness. You guys really love abortion, don't you? Absolutely. Hey, well, don't worry. Don't worry that, you know, you guys love garbing yourself in black like you're tough. You love death so much, believe me. God's got a way of giving you what you want. So enjoy it. I think you guys are a fascinating topic. We're going to start covering you guys. I hope you enjoy it.
Yeah, they have so many people with them.
Absolutely. Total minions of evil. Yeah, we already know who you are. Not releasing your names isn't going to help. And the rap sheets on these guys are going to be very, very serious. I need to talk to the police.
Again, the only
response
is... I need
to speak to the officers. I want to send Weldon. Yeah, we need to speak to the police. All right, I'm going over here. Bring me the cameras. Listen, it's all right, buddy. I'm going to go talk to this guy. I'll do what I want. Thank you. Hey, how you doing?
Doing well.
When are the officers going to come over, please, sir?
Shortly.
Fantastic. You promise you'll ask him to come over to us?
Guarantee.
Okay, thank you. Well, we need to arrest him. We have video of him assaulting people. Not like the assault going on inside there, but it's, they're not cutting up babies or anything. They're just here like Renfield protecting Dracula's castle. But it doesn't work, ladies and gentlemen. Absolutely. That guy was like a reanimated corpse. I'm telling you, these people are the scum of the earth. God. I wouldn't be surprised if God just blew the whole planet up to cleanse it of this disease and blew us up along with it. I mean, this is just, what did you, sir, I saw one of the minions was attacking you. What was, did you see the look in their eyes?
Crazed look, just out in space. I mean, the guy had to.
I mean, it's beyond the